I just went to all the states in the lower 48 to have a local beer. Let me tell you how it went. First observation, it was awesome. Secondly, let's have a look at the data. The most common style of beer I had was the IPA. I had it 12 times, and 14 if you want to count New England IPA and West Coast IPA more specifically. Why that is, I think, is just because it's a very popular style in the US. For example, if you go to a gas station and they only carry one craft beer, 9 times out of 10 it's going to be a craft beer. So that's why I think that happened. My second most common style was any German style beer, whether that's Bock, Alt beer, Helles Doppelbock. I lumped it all together, and together I had 5 of those types of beer. I had 4 pale ales, 3 general ales, it just said ale on the can, nothing else, 2 brown ales, 2 sours, which I think is really surprising because that's my favorite style of beer. So good job me for trying to expand your horizons. Too bad it didn't really work out with having so much IPAs. I had 2 lagers, 2 blonde ales, 2 red ales, 2 amber ales, and 2 wheat beers. I also had 1 Pilsner, golden ale, farmhouse ale, Scottish ale, porter, stout, and Mexican lager. So kind of a variety overall. I also kept track of where I drank it. My goal was to drink beer in a beautiful place because that's the name of my channel, but that didn't always end up happening. 4 times I had beer just in my van with the windows covered up. It's my home, so I think it's beautiful in its own way, but you know, it's not out in nature. 10 times I had my official beer of the state at a brewery, bar, or restaurant. Sometimes it was a really cool outdoor restaurant or something, but usually that happened on the East Coast and in the South, not necessarily because of where I was, but because it was winter and fall when I was there, and I was like, well, if I go to a brewery, I can hang out in a warm building instead of being out in my van. 2 times I had my official beer of the state in a kayak, and I went kayaking 4 times on the trip, and every time I brought beer with me. What I mean by my official beer of the state was a lot of times I drank multiple beers in each state. You know, I wasn't there just for one beer and leaving. So I had to just choose 1 for this data, and it was usually either the first beer or the most memorable. 18 times I had a beer in my van, or like I am now, just outside at my campsite. But 14 times I had beer in a really cool spot out in nature. That was out on trail, on top of mountains, around the rim of the Grand Canyon. Sometimes I would just be driving and see a really cool lookout and have a beer there. I also counted a restaurant in South Carolina in this cool places category because it was literally a deck over the ocean. And I just thought, like, I counted that as a cool place outside, even though technically it was a restaurant. And let me tell you what I learned about craft beer in different regions of the US. Here, it was a little harder to find craft beer because of the popularity of mass-produced beer. And in the South, I noticed that a lot of times I'd find a local brewery, but they would have an option on their menu to recommend to people who are used to drinking mass-produced beer. Which was really interesting to me because in places where craft beer is the most popular thing, you know, you wouldn't even think to do that. The places I came that I felt like really loved craft beer were Charlotte, North Carolina, Flagstaff, Arizona, Denver, Colorado, Maine, and the Pacific Northwest. It's interesting though because all those places have nature nearby them. And that just proves my theory that nature and beer go hand in hand. So, shout out to all the breweries. You all should work with me. At first, when I was thinking of differences by region, I thought that West Coast IPA was harder to find than East Coast IPA, but there's only 3 states on the East Coast, so I had less of a chance to find it than the, you know, 13 or however many states that are on the East Coast. I also noticed that the vibe inside breweries is very similar wherever you go. A lot of them have stained wood, corrugated iron, Edison light bulbs hanging down, maybe a chalkboard menu. I'm not saying that's a bad thing, not saying they copied off each other. It's just nice that wherever you go, it's a similar vibe. I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm kind of fighting the sunset here to get this recorded before it goes down. In Kentucky, I had Survive, American Pilsner by Country Boy. In Indiana, I had Dragonfly IPA by Upland. In Illinois, I had APA, which stands for American Pale Ale, by Brickstone. In Minnesota, I had Trampled, American Golden Ale by Bent Paddle. In Wisconsin, I had Spotted Cow, which is a farmhouse ale by New Glarus. In Michigan, I had Upper Peninsula Ale, Pale Ale, by Upper Hand Brewing. In Ohio, I had Who Cooks For You by Jackie O's. Oh, and that's a hazy pale ale. In Pennsylvania, I had Wynona's Big Brown Ale by Voodoo Brewing. In New York, I had Leaf Peeper Supreme, German-style lager by Paradox. In Vermont, I had Long Trail Ale by Long Trail Brewing Company. New Hampshire was Full Clip NEIPA by Stoneface Brewing Company. In Maine, I had Slim Hazy Local IPA by Peak Organic Brewing. In Massachusetts, I had A Year with Dr. Nandu American IPA by Aeronaut Brewing. In Rhode Island, I had 12 O'Clock High IPA by Rejects Beer Co. That was the one that tasted straight up like Sunny D. In Connecticut, I had a sour by Stargazer Brewing Company. Which exact sour? I don't remember, but I know it was raspberry. It was very good. In New Jersey, I had West Coast IPA by Gusto. In Delaware, I had Not Today Satan IPA by Mispillion River Brewing Company. In Maryland, I had Loose Cannon IPA by Heavy Seas Beer. In Virginia, I had 8 Point IPA by Devil's Backbone. In West Virginia, I had Devil Ants IPA by Greenbrier Valley Brewing. In Tennessee, I had Yeehaw 80 Scottish Ale by Yeehaw Brewing Company. In North Carolina, I had Jade IPA by Foothills Brewing, and that was at the most unique place of the whole trip. It was called the Brew Pump, and it was a brewery, not a brewery, but a bar built into a gas station. So you'd look outside and see people pumping their gas. So unique. In South Carolina, I had Idle Speed Salted Lime Lager by Palmetto Brewing Company. If anyone from Palmetto Brewing Company sees this, I'm very sorry, but that was actually my least favorite beer. The salted lime lager, it was definitely like the taste of a margarita, but that's not what I want to taste in a beer. Which is weird because I have sours that taste like candy and I have porters that taste like chocolate, but for some reason, those flavors translate to beer for me, but not margaritas. In Georgia, I had New Wave Radical Blonde Ale. In Florida, I had Strawberry Float American Lager by Swamphead Brewing. In Alabama, I had Beer Here Now German Style Ale by Braided River Brew Co. In Mississippi, I had Curlew's Coconut Porter by Chandelure Island Brewing. In Louisiana, I had Andy Gator Helles Doppelbock by Abita Brewing. In Texas, I had the Statement of Purpose Peanut Butter Golden Stout. In New Mexico, I had Pepe Loco Mexican Style Lager by Santa Fe Brew Co. In Arizona, I had Trail Hike IPA. Never heard anyone use the word trail hike before. You can go on a hiking trail or do a hike on a trail. I guess I just don't get what they were. I don't know. I don't mean to pick on them. Anyway, it was by Grand Canyon Brewing. In Utah, I had Color Country Red Ale by Silver Reef Brewing Company. Colorado, I had Winter Stoke Irish Style Red Ale by Highside Brewing. In Kansas, I had Ad Astra Amber Ale by Free State Brewing. Oklahoma was Rainbow Sherbet, which is a sour ale by Prairie Artisanal Ales. In Arkansas, I had Love Honey Bock by Lost 40 Brewing. In Missouri, I had Unfiltered Wheat Beer by Boulevard Brewing. In Iowa, I had Pappy's American Ale by Maquoketa Brewing. In Nebraska, I had Copper Alt, which is an alt beer by Zipline Brewing Company. In South Dakota, I had 11th Hour IPA Ale. That's what it said on the can, IPA Ale, even though IPA stands for Indian Pale Ale. Anyway, that was by Crow Peak Brewing Company. In North Dakota, I had Pronghorn Peach Wheat by Fat Fish Brewing. Montana was Moose Drool Brown Ale by Big Sky Brewing Company. In Washington, I had Lush IPA by Fremont Brewing. In Oregon, I had Sweet As Pacific Ale by Good Life Brewing Company. California, I had Pale Ale by Sierra Nevada Brewing Co. In Nevada, I had Drink Local Blonde Ale by Lead Dog Brewing. In Idaho, I had Angel's Perch Amber Ale by Sockeye Brewing. And lastly, in Wyoming, I had Cowboy Gold Kolsch Style Ale by Snake River Brewing. And we're just finishing as the sun is setting. Now, drinking beer in nature was usually a really good time. But in order to do that experience, I had to go through some trials and tribulations. So if you're interested, I will link on your screen right now my documentary I made about the whole experience. Thank you for watching. Have a good rest of your day.